I got a pillow once that said, you're special, okay? You know what? My family loves me, and I am not ashamed.
Seriously super, stupid sleepover!
Hello, everybody!
Hi.
It's sleepover!
Today we have two really special freaking guests over.
Thomas Sanders, everybody!
Would you say I'm the cat's pajamas?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry!
Here we are, we're having a sleepover, we're gonna play some freaking games!
It's called Mobcinity, and we played this before.
Yes,
on previous episodes.
Snack Snail, when you jump out, you hinge spot and slap a friend.
We got this deck of cards, and each card has a word, and you put two words together, and it makes a whole new word. And we each have our clipboards.
Thanks. Oh, I shouldn't put the paws back on.
So we all have these clipboards, and we each have to make up a new definition for this word combo. And then when we all have made our definitions, we all put our cards together, shuffle them up, and switch them around. And then the judge, whoever's the judge for that round, will have them read them off and then make them either act it out, sing it, or put it in a sentence, or cry.
Yeah.
I call crying.
I'm just gonna pull a card and read it out loud.
Pull two cards. I'm so freaking excited.
Milk. Grind on that milk grind.
Milk grind. Grind. All right, ready, go!
When I was like 14, I liked to play on Xbox Live. And so like I would play and I got the microphone and I guess my voice was really high pitched at the time, but I wasn't aware of it. So I would play online and this was my first experience ever making any sort of online friends. And I was like, wow, I can speak to people who are older than me and I'm playing games with them. That's really cool. So I'd play Gears of War 2 online. And I made friends with this guy. He was called Tub something. I just remember his name had a tub in it. So I'd always call him Tub. We would play pretty often. I would say we played like twice, maybe three times a week, Gears of War. And this went on for maybe like 2-3 months. And then I randomly got a message from him and it asked, are you a girl? to which I responded, cause I was like, what? No, like it was like in a message format. So I just sent back the message no with a question mark. And then we stopped playing games together. and I don't think I was fully aware at the time that that's why that he was playing with me because he thought I was a girl. but I still tried to play with him every now and then and he just wouldn't respond. So that's my story today.
Good job.
Courtney, what do you think milk grind means?
I think it's chewing the leftover expired milk you have in the fridge.
Oh, gross.
Listen, I'm not convinced unless I hear it usually in some sort of like European voice. So could you do like a kind German man trying to convince me that I should try his native milk grind?
Oh yeah, okay.
Your best.
Okay. Oh, yum, look at this carton of milk that I have had since April. It is very good. You shake it around, it sounds like rocks. You got to open up, twist it, but then you're like, oh no, can't get the rocks out, so you got to take a machete. It's turning into Italian. So here is your Italian cheese milk grind. You take it and you dump it out and you take it with a fork and you. You got to try it.
I love it.
That was great.
Milk grind, it's when you're working on the farm and you're just pushing the cows around the field. Just doing it.
Just doing it.
No, you're back to that farmer grind. I feel it. Let's say I wanted to get into this milk grind. What would you suggest I do?
First of all, on this farm, you must know how to speak to roosters. You only sleep for 4 hours and you wake up like this. Cock-a-doodle-doo.
It's like Westworld.
I don't want to work there. You know what? I'll keep my answer to myself, but it's not looking bright. Wait. What is your definition of the milk grind?
Oh, my definition of milk grind. Get ready. It's living on a farm is, you know, sometimes hard, especially on Tuesdays, right? Mm-hmm. Am I right?
Yeah.
The cows are brats sometimes. I don't know, you know. And they are stubborn with their milk ducts. So we, the farmers, have to be very diligent with the cow nipples. Am I right? Do I still have you?
Yes.
You know?
You do.
It's tough, but every Tuesday we are on our milk grind.
You gotta be diligent with the nipples.
Gotta be diligent with the nipples. I think that's a motto.
How would you? Yeah. Can you show me? How are you diligent with the nipples?
Oh man!
If there were four nipples,
how should you show it?
Noah, like, I'm so glad you asked.
I think a song.
Yeah, a song.
When I wake up to see my cows, I say, are you ready to deliver milk now? They say my nipples aren't really ripe. So I use my hands and I treat them right.
Yes!
I squirt, squirt, here it is.
God.
That is a milk grind. That is a milk grind if I've ever heard one.
He literally was like, I don't know if I can do the what.
You're not gonna make me sing, are you? I don't know if I'm ready for that.
That was amazing.
That was so good.
Yeah, that was a milk grind. That was a weekly. You gotta be diligent with those cow nipples every week. But just to review really quick, we're on that milk grind, which means either German milk rocks.
Oh yeah, try the milk rocks. They are so good. You do your milk grind with them.
Also got the milk grind, which is somehow waking up while making the sound of a rooster and then getting hurt. We've also got the milk grind, which is being diligent weekly to your cow's nipples needs. And I think that is the best definition of milk grind. So that one goes to my friend Thomas.
Yay!
Okay, so you obviously made the definition of the diligent nipples. Because that took forever. I'm guessing you were on the, whatever she turned into, waking up every week to a rooster, and then you were on those rocks. You were about that milk cheese.
No. I had the curdled milk.
Yeah, and then I had the pushing cows around.
Yeah. That's what the milk grind was.
Yeah.
Strawberry.
Ooh, they're
That's
good.
Great. Love strawberries. And strum.
Strawberry strum!
That's such great alliteration. All right, I need to know what strawberry strum may be.
Okay.
Just sounds great.
Ready, set, go.
This is interesting. So I actually, you know, I'm a big fan of social media, right? I'm a big fan of online gaming. And when I was younger, I used to go online. There wasn't a lot of people to play with, but I found this one great person I used to play around with. I was like, what should my username be? So I was like, you know, strangely enough, I had my system set up in the bathroom. So I was like, oh, Tub. All right. So I was like, that's gonna be my username, Tubbs. And I was just like, you know, at the time I was a little curious as to. I was playing, I felt comfortable, and I didn't know a lot about the female gender, and I wanted to, like, you know, ask an innocent question to my playmate, you know, are you a girl? And they said, no, ? And I was like, oh, okay, well, no big deal. At that point, though, my mom came into the bathroom and like, why are you playing video games in the bathroom? That's dumb. So disconnected my whole system, and I felt really bad because I didn't get to play with him ever since then. It's kind of really... really sad. I hope that he's doing okay.
Were you the guy playing with Noah on the...
You know, I...
Are you Tubbs?
I never thought about that. Hey, Noah. Are you the person that I played with video games?
What?
Tubbs. What? Tubbs.
Wait, what? Noah, are you a boy or a girl?
What was your username?
PirateHooker214.
Fantastic! Oh my goodness,
oh
Pirate
my
Hooker!
God!
You're Tubbs?
No! I'm Tubbs!
Dude, I don't want to talk to you.
Oh.
Well, look, bro, you broke my heart.
I'm sorry. Look, my mom broke my heart. All right? Let's play video games again soon, okay?
Yes.
I got a new system now.
What do you have?
It's not in the bathroom. PS4?
Yeah, it's not going to work out.
Oh!
All
right. Ooh,
I got two.
Okay.
Thanks.
No, you judged last time, so please tell me what a strawberry strum is, because I'm very curious.
Well, strawberry strum is actually strawberries rum. It was actually the author of James Bond's favorite drink, specifically when he lived in Jamaica. That is what they would serve him, a form of strawberry rum. But when he brought it over, I think it was some sort of issue with the accents. So he would say strawberry strum or strawberry rum, and they would come back with strawberry strum, and then
totally
it just kind of
got... It's a little strange. That seems like a hard story to believe.
Let me try doing the accent. You'd probably believe that it was like lost in communication.
Great. Could you reenact like him trying to like,
yeah,
you know,
so,
order that
so
drink?
If I was the author of James Bond, he's obviously British, so I would try to go and I would be like, hello, people of Jamaica, could I have a strawberries rum? A strawberries rum? And they would be
just
like,
asking
oh,
the whole, all people of
Jamaica. Oh, yeah, man. I will get you strawberry strum. So there you go. It's kind of difficult. And then
and
imagine
he just gave
him.
Up from there.
Yeah, and then him on his famous James Bond tour signing books in Barnes and Nobles across the United States. He then would go to all the local bars at night and ask for then a strawberry strum. And they would not know what he meant, and he would usually just end up with a Coors. But he tried.
The next best thing.
Yeah.
Well, Courtney. Okay. I don't know. Maybe you can give me
maybe
a different
can,
take on strawberry
some light
strum
on the situation. Yeah,
because
okay.
I'm still a little not convinced.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Okay, strawberry strum is a food native to the Amish of the Philly Hills. It is a mixture of leftover fruid skins from jam creation and bovine bone marrow. It is usually served in rainy months, where it is enjoyed indoors and nude.
Oh,
it was fruit skin.
Sorry, I got bad handwriting.
Oh my goodness. Okay, so we're two very different drink options here.
Food. This is more a food.
It's more a food. Okay, a so jam. Food. You could serve strawberry strum with strawberry strum and have a great meal.
Oh, that'd be so good.
Right? Could you show me the preparation of that food in dance form?
Okay. Yes.
Could you? Yeah.
Are you tired of eating foods that are not as good as what they see in the outside world? What? I'm doing like a commercial dance.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Well, you can make your own food that's really good, and it is from the fruits of jams.
She almost punched me in the face.
And jams, and it's the skin. And you pick it, and you skin it, and you eat it.
That was very
beautiful.
Nice.
I could almost taste that strawberry strum.
Sorry for almost assaulting you.
You're great. It would have been fun. Very,
my favorite
very
part
convincing.
Was it was a commercial for me to make it myself. Don't buy my product.
Make it. I'm sold. But not quite. Olivia, I probably need one more possibility as to what strawberry strum may be. So could you please enlighten me?
Strawberry strum. IMDb. Strawberry strum is an alternative band from the 90s consisting of four red-headed prepubescent boys who got dumped in band class.
I'm like very intrigued by this. Could you give me maybe a song that Strawberry Strum
okay.
has performed? Because that sounds great. Boys. Redheaded prepubescent boys. Oh my goodness. Okay, what are their songs like?
My life sucks like hell. Kinda like the color of my freaking hair.
Okay. Kind of worked.
That's amazing.
It really came around.
You know what? That sounds legit. Okay, so but we have an alcoholic drink that the author of James Bond drank from Jamaica. He ordered that. We also have an Amish food that's created from the skins of fruits.
Fruit skins from the Amish.
Beautiful. And we also have a prepubescent band of redheads that created a band. I said band twice. You know what? I'm interested in buying an album from Strawberry Strum. So I think I'm gonna have to go with Olivia.
Yay!
Okay, so alcoholic drink was Olivia.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good job.
The food, the Amish food, was made by Noah. And Strawberry Strum IMDb was Courtney.
Yes.
Nailed it! Freaking nailed it!
Cheesy scallop potatoes.
Captain Punch.
Captain Punish.
Oh, man.
This is a hard one.
But you could go out of the box or inside the box, but not a circle because circles don't fit on boxes.
Okay, ready, set, go.
Oh, starting now. What do you want to know?
One time in middle school, I was walking down the street with my best friend Heidi Lamb, and I had a rolling backpack, and it was like around 4:30, like way after school, and we went across the street and got some Thai iced tea, and then we're just like having a good time waiting for our ride. And then like I was running really fast with my rolling backpack. I would do tricks with it, you know? And like 4:30 after school, that's when you want to like do tricks with your rolling backpack. I would swirl it around and like go like this and swing it. And then like these group of girls saw me do that and they pushed me. And I was like, why'd you do that?
Is there a moral to the story?
Don't push girls with rolling backpacks.
Thomas, would you like to go first?
Oh, okay. All right, so it's Captain Punish. Punish. Mm-hmm. Captain Punish. That's right. Punish Captain, Pun-ish Captain, also known as Carl Brenton, was just a normal captain of a Coast Guard vessel until lightning struck, resulting in him getting hospitalized for 6 months. He returned to work with a new sense of optimism. Now he weaves sea-level puns in his orders, tie your shoe knots. Huh? I couldn't even tell you what that pun meant if I tried.
Can you please explain this? Like an evil scientist.
Yes. Well, one fair day, Captain Brenton was at sea, and all of a sudden, a storm broke out from the horizon. Lightning striking from the abyss above. I don't even know if that's possible, but there's an abyss above. The lightning forsooth struck Captain Brenton right here upon the temple. He was out. For 7 days. Upon those 7 days, he saw night terrors that ransacked his very being. And all he could do to keep himself sane in those moments of darkness were to entertain himself with lighthearted humor, he was once told by a horrible English teacher he had in third grade. Yes, that was the worst kind of humor, right? Upon waking, that was all he knew. He set out upon the sea once more with those sea-level puns, striking fear and groans into the people he governed upon those seas.
Oh, wow! Oh, wow! Oh, wow. Oh, there's the scientist lie! Oh, yeah. They freaking nailed it.
Your turn.
My turn? Okay, Captain Punish. An 1800s pirate known for his off-putting and groan-inducing humor. They weren't even good puns, one pirate wrote. They were just sort of punished.
It's like two people like knew like the same went for the same thing here. That's so weird.
Oh my god.
Can you please present this like you are a B-level stand-up comedian?
Okay. All right.
Hey, hey, yeah, yeah. Hey, 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 what do you call a pug that's really slow?
What do you call a pug that's really slow?
A slug.
Yeah.
Thank you. What do you call him? Hey, everybody, what do you call a man that works in a moving company and he has to put things in boxes really fast?
What?
Pac-Man.
All right.
Wow. That was great. Okay, Noah?
Captain Punish, it's when the captain was a naughty boy on his ship and the crew has to call his mom. And the mom comes to the ship on a raft of octopuses and then she puts soap in his mouth.
All right. Wow. Okay.
Yeah. Okay,
wow.
So how should he...
I feel like you should do it like Russell Crowe's character in Les Mis.
Gather! I cannot take one day more of his puns. He is rude. He has been handing out wet willies too much. Come, we shall build a raft of octopus and get his mother on board with soap. Now, together, one day more.
Yeah! Good job, Noah.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
Very,
Russell
very
Crowe's
good.
Actually one of my favorite actors.
Oh man, this is so hard. I honestly can't choose.
You have to.
I'm really indecisive.
Who does win?
Let me talk to my lemur really quick. Okay, we recap. He was evil scientist.
Yeah.
Evil scientist.
Evil scientist. Ooh. I was a stand-up comedian.
You're comedian. Russell Crowe. I think I'm gonna give it to Russell Crowe.
Yeah!
Cards.
Cards. Right there. Right there.
I'm gonna guess who did whose. You read his.
Yeah, you did.
I read his, yes.
Yeah, okay.
Which is why I had to keep a straight face.
And you guys had similar thoughts.
That's so,
so you
crazy.
Read Thomas's.
I did?
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
And Courtney's. Was Noah's.
Yep.
Yeah. Read mine.
That was really great.
That was really
You're
good.
Creative. You're Thank a creative you. Soul.
I'm a judge.
No,
yet.
You gotta judge.
Yes.
Okay. I gotta win more points
yes.
so I can. Wait, everyone who's playing this round has 1 point. So that means that this is like a tiebreaker round to see who wins.
Everybody in this round has 1 point. Oh,
that's
my
right.
goodness.
Let's see who can win.
Oh, dear.
Okay, this is the winning points. Dude, this is perfect for the tiebreaker. It's one word, and then this one says play three cards.
Oh. Oh.
So this is gonna be a four word term.
Damn.
What?
That's freaking right. Okay. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
She's just remembering a joke she heard yesterday.
I was thinking about my stand up.
Oh my God.
Okay, this is slug. The word is. Pump dragon crack burst.
whoa, I'm writing that down. Hold on.
Pump dragon crack burst.
That's amazing.
I thought about this story the other day, something that happened to me a long time ago. I think one night my parents weren't home, and so my oldest siblings threw a party. And they had lots of kids over, but I was super, super young. I think I was like 7. Or like 8 or 9, and I was locked in my room. They would not let me out into the party or like see anything, or I think they were trying to like make me think that there wasn't a party going on, but there clearly was, like in the house that like was one small door was in between us. And I remember that it was nighttime and I would start getting paranoid that the blinds were open because it was dark and I can't see outside when it's dark and they can see inside. And so I decided to get them shut, but they're too high, so I just stand up on the desk. But I also wasn't wearing pants. So I was wearing a shirt and just some undies and stood up on the desk and was shutting the blinds. And I was like this, like that. And then I remember hearing the door open behind me and I just turn and I'm like, ooh. And like there's straight up this teenage boy who had entered and was like, ooh, and just shut the door. Like I remember not even reacting when it happened. And I think it was because I was so used to having people walk in on me because I had 6 siblings. So like, it was just like another day, just getting walked in on in my panties.
Noah, go first.
Pump Dragon Crack Burst. Pump Dragon, as he likes to be known, is a WWE wrestler. He is a big boy and did so much steroids. One day, White Bucky fought him. And White Bucky uppercutted him so hard his esophagus bursted out of his neck. He died of a mean uppercut. Many artisan restaurants have named a style of deviled egg after this epic warrant. It is as popular as the California roll.
Okay.
Well, boy, that makes me hungry.
I
just thinking
understand
about it.
Completely. Mm-hmm. But would you just humor me, if you could be Pump Dragon, the WWE wrestler. He's just entered the ring, and this is his opening speech to intimidate his opponent before he died. He didn't know he was gonna die, I bet.
My name is Pump Dragon, and I wanna let you know, White Bucky, that you will not defeat me today unless for some reason you were able to sneak an uppercut directly onto my chin. I want you to know, recently I have gotten esophageal
surgery because I could not swallow naturally. I had to go like this a lot. That was due to my large amount of steroid intake, so avoid this area when we fight.
That's amazing.
Oh my god, yeah. Weighing 125 pounds, Pump Dragon!
Closer to 119!
Yeah, dude, that was amazing.
It's amazing he didn't really see his impending death.
Yeah.
Wow. The Pump Dragon Crackburst. You may not know, but recently declassified documents show the first time law enforcement captured a high-level crack cocaine dealer known as Pump Dragon, all right? This was integral in stopping the crack cocaine wave. The first sales of crack in the USA are known as the Pump Dragon Crack Burst.
Let me ask you a question,
all right.
Thomas.
All right.
Can you speak to rhythm or rap? Would you do that for me?
You're asking me to rap.
Rap of the notorious.
You're asking me to rap.
Yes.
Oh,
Pump
boy.
Dragon. We're all friends here. If you could do that.
All right.
About okay. The notorious Pump Dragon and the burst of the crack.
Cool.
If you need a beat, please. You have many people at your disposal. People
yeah,
here.
There we go. Mm-hmm. Yeah, start it up. Rhythm's good. Rhythm's good. Yo, let me tell you all, guys, a tale about how we got the great white whale, Pump Dragon. Yeah, that's his name. He came to America, and this is his fame. He sold crack. First time ever that was told. He sold more than was worth in gold. And pretty soon they took him down, but you're never gonna top that famous clown. He's got so much more in this great wide world than you're ever gonna find out. That's it, girl.
I am lightheaded.
Okay, well, there you go. There you go. That's the next, you know, you've heard of Alexander Hamilton. Mm-hmm. That's the next Broadway show, rap
Dragon.
Show.
That you're,
Lin-Manuel's already on it.
Now I'm real shook.
Okay. All right, Olivia, it's your turn. I don't know how you're going to follow that. Yeah.
That's going to be impossible.
All right. Give me what you got, girl.
Pump Dragon Crackburst. A devastating day in London's history when a gigantic air-filled dragon balloon collided with the big hand on Big Ben, popping it and causing the dragon to wreak actual havoc upon the town. Not the unfilling balloon. I'm talking about the fact that it set the time on Big Ben forward 1 hour.
Oh my gosh.
Mm. Mm. But it was like a traumatizing hour.
They were like, oh my gosh, like I don't know when my
tie is
going
to be done. It took 15 minutes for them to reset it, but still.
Yeah. Olivia,
yes.
Could you be the big gigantic balloon on the parade floating over the town and interpret what happened that day?
If you need us to maybe be in the stage with you is in this play, or would you rather, I'll be a child licking a lollipop.
I'll be a gentleman scholar.
Oh, look, it's a balloon coming back.
Quiet now, sweet pop.
Okay.
What is it doing?
Oh gosh, oh, it's drifting.
Oh no, wait, it shouldn't go that
Where
far.
Where is it going?
Wait.
Oh no!
Where are the strings that tether it? No!
Oh God!
No! Wait, why is it going? Why is Big Ben's?
Guys, it's 3 o'clock now.
Good job, baby. That was a real group effort.
I think that's gonna get a Tony this year.
Let's recap this big boy.
If
huh?
you don't remember, Pump Dragon Crackburst was actually when the famous WWE wrestler Pump Dragon was uppercutted by a white Bucky.
Okay, and then?
Yeah, the Pump Dragon Crackburst was actually, Pump Dragon was a crack dealer, the first one to sell it in the United States.
Yeah, okay. And the rap told the story so perfectly.
Beautiful, yep.
And then we had your amazing Shakespearean reenactment of the great Pump Dragon Crackburst.
Basically, a balloon hit the Big Ben.
You know what? I really love the WWE wrestler, so I think I'm gonna give Noah all the cards.
Yay!
You win!
You wrote the wrestler one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You wrote the drug dealer one. And then you wrote the Big Ben.
Yes.
Yay! Okay, yes. Sweet!
Boom.
Nailed it. All right, guys, ready? On to the next game? Because we got one last
Wait,
game.
Wait, can I just announce that I won first?
Yay!
Yay, Noah!
We're back and we switch seats.
What?
Fun.
Wow. All right, so this game is called Kazoo.
Kazoo.
So we all have a kazoo. And there is this yellow box. And inside this box, there are different types of songs. And each of us, we're gonna pick out one
and we're gonna read it, and then we're gonna kazoo the song, and then we all have to guess what song it is. Noah, do you wanna go first?
I would love to go first.
Here you go.
Oh, dear.
Don't be.
I didn't see. Beep, 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 beep.
Cake by the ocean. I think it's like,
cake
talk to me, baby.
That's what it is.
More sounds out of my mouth, uh-huh.
Perfect.
Wait for the chorus.
Yes.
It's coming and you love it.
Cake by the ocean.
Okay.
And take your picture. My homeboy tried to warn me.
But by Sir Mix-a-Lot. Yeah.
Yes. I love that one.
Yep.
Okay.
What is it? My love, call me by cell phone. Boop, 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 boop. Girl, I'm gonna be my love. And you know when I holla me. You need one thing.
There you go. You got it.
You know when you're
hotline bling. Don't look.
Okay, sorry. Okay. I didn't see it. How does that one start?
Man.
Wait, right?
Snapchat filter.
That's good.
Round, round and round, the wheels on the bus go round and round. All through town or through town, I don't know which one.
Through the town.
Move around, go around, the wheels on the bus round and round. All through my frown.
Wow. We need to go back to school and learn that song again. Bye. Nope.
No.
All right, here we go.
I love you, Noah.
Ready?
Dancer that's like
Maggie.
Yeah, Maggie.
Oh, I love doing her. Okay.
Yeah, do it, do it.
Get some more.
I wanna shine like a bird from the night. Zoot is right. Boom mic!
I'm gonna swing from the boom microphone.
From the boom microphone.
Good job.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, that was really good.
The last one, everybody.
You came for lightning. It's every time it shoots.
No? Okay.
No, you got it.
That's like the only words I know.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. You.
What You Came For by Calvin Harris.
Yeah.
Thank you, Thomas, for being here. Thank you, Noah. Thank you, Cow.
Thank you, little toy. Cow guy.
Thank you, Thomas. Thank you, Olivia. Thank you, Courtney.
Thomas, where can they find you?
Oh, they can find me at youtube.com/ThomasSanders.
Yeah. Perfect.
More videos.
Yeah, post in the comments. What are the games you play here? What are the games you want to see again? If you want to see here, if you want to see Thomas again, let us know. And yeah, I think it's time a little bit.
That was super fun.
Okay.
Yes.
let's go to bed. And maybe we can like hum a tune.
Yep.
A lullaby, okay?
Ready?
Lullaby.
But go to sleep, on the
ready, go to sleep.
Let's lay with the
You cracked my soda pop!
I want to thank you, Universe, for your, for Olivia's chicken hat. It might, some people may consider it turkeys, but I like chicken, so.
Hurry up, the whipped cream's getting runny!
Oh, yeah,
preach!
Peace and hair grease, power to the people, and Keith Lee for President 2020, y'all.
Amen! Wait.